Okay, hello my friend, and how are you doing? And next I am planning to show you that how to repaint this car mask grille. And now I have in here this Toyota car's grille, and next I am planning to paint this my color to blue. And now this is like gray, but soon I am planning to paint that color to blue. And of course, you like to ask that why I am planning to paint this my mask, and there is this grille. That why I am planning to do this job, and there is reason that this my current car's grille, what is blue, it is damaged, and there is now damage in this area, and because there is some heats in here. And now I have purchased this second hand this grille, and this is from this recycle center, and that grille cost about 60 or 70 US dollars, and this is like used, and this come from Toyota car, what is now like scrap, and there is. But this car is full of usable car parts, like in this grille. And now I am planning to only paint that my grille. Okay. And how to do this paint? How I can paint this my new, like reuse an old grille to my car's color? Because now this is like gray or little bit brown, and my car's color is blue. And what I need to do? Okay, first thing is that we need to visit in our this car makers, like this Toyota's dealership center, and I need to purchase this specific my car paint. And in here, when we look, this my car paint is dark blue, and this code is 8P4. 8P4 is this color code 8P4, and this is just excellent quality paint, because this lasts long, and this is like base color and paint in here, and in final step I need to insert in here this second paint in this lacier like lock. That I paint that in this final paint in second time, that there is this shiny paint, you know, this clear coat paint. Okay, but what next? If I have this spare part, and then I have purchased this my car's this spray paint from Toyota dealership, then I need some another parts. I need high quality this duct tape or paint, this tape, and this Scott is excellent brand, I recommend that. And then I need sandpaper, and now this sandpaper, it must be in very, very fine and very soft sandpaper. Something like 400 is good. And I have that kind of sanding paper, what is about 400. And now my first task is to remove this shiny, this lacier paint, this clear coat in here, and I need that 400 sandpaper, and I only now take this shiny away in only this paint areas, not in this metallic areas, only shiny. And the purpose is that why I do that, there is thing that when I take this shiny away, then this my spray paint takes better contact. And that's the reason why I need to use this sandpaper when I do paintings. And And now this is like first step, and then actually first step is to insert this tape, Scotch tape in here, and all of these metallic areas. And it happens so that I start this my job so that I have my tape, and in that area in here I insert that just in this side very carefully. Look in that way. And there is important that I do this my job carefully, and look like in example in here, when we go to look that closer, that what I am doing, there is then this my paint area, and now I need to insert this my tape in here, and it is good to insert just in carefully in that line in here, and look that my work. Now we can see better. I insert my tape in here very carefully, and then I press my fingers in here in that way, and then in that way, and in that way here. And then I have to do this my job in all of these metallic areas, also in this logo area, and then this upper area in here I have to insert my tape in carefully in here, in that way, and then I can move that my direction a little bit in that way, and I move that my paint good. And now this area is fine, and in that position I can insert this on both sides. And next my job is to insert that tape in all of this chrome and this silver areas where is this metallic paint, and then when I have made that job we can continue, and also in here are these areas. And next I insert this paint and tape, and then when tape is ready we can continue. Okay, and now I have inserted this my tape in all areas, and also in that upper area and the central logo. And now I notice that in the central area I need to insert a little bit more tape. Okay, and now this logo is off, and now this job is, I only little bit check that there is no any those things, that this my tape is too far away, and if it is too far away we can take sharp tool and remove it in that way. And now this my tape and protection is ready, and next step is to sandpaper all of these shiny areas in that way. Look. And this is for reason that this my paint takes good contact, and only that I remove this shiny, and 400 is this sandpaper's number. Still good. And then I will sandpaper all of these areas in here, from here to here. And it takes couple of minutes, and also in here, that areas, and then we can look my result next, and we continue soon. Okay, and now I have sandpaper all of these areas in using this my sandpaper. And now this shiny area is away, and also in these areas, and in here everything looks good. And then I have to do my next step, And I have to take this thinner. This is liquid, but it's very, very poison, but extremely good cleaner. And then cotton cloth, and also use protective gloves, because this thinner liquid in here, in that one, it is really poison. But let's look, because thinner cleans things, and I insert in here this my thinner, and in that way. And then look, there is this thinner, and work in outside. And now I take with this thinner this all grease and those small sand particles away. Look, this is totally black. And then I change a little bit this position. And this thinner makes this painting surface excellent. And paint color takes excellent contact. Look, this is black. And also in here. And remember, this is really poison material, and it damages our brains. And that do not work in any, do not work inside, because then you might have damage in brain. This is the thing. But now I think that this is clean. Look, this was starting point white, and it takes so much dirt is away. And then I can start to soon paint this my thing, and I insert that in that position. And then I have to keep that like drying about 10 minutes, that this thinner liquid goes away, and it actually vapors, and it is like air. Okay, and we wait 10 minutes, and then we continue. Okay, and then I am planning to paint that. I insert in here. And there is this my paint color. And first I need to shake and rotate that about 1 minute in every direction. In that way. And I can actually shake that little bit, and soon we continue. Okay, and now I am planning to paint that. And there is arrow. And this yellow paint, that in what direction paint goes. And then I start in here, and I go all areas through. And here this blue start first in that way. And then there must be this paint so much that it looks like blue. Looks good. Excellent. Then I continue in that area. And I move a little bit my cue. Okay. And then I loop all areas that okay, excellent. And now this my paint looks very good. And then I have to wait about 30 minutes, and then I repaint with that spray paint that area again. Okay, good. Okay, and now when I have waited about 30 minutes, and this my paint is dry, I can add in here this final paint. What is this clear coat? And this is like glossier, clear, shiny surface. And of course I have shaked at my spray bottle about couple of minutes, and then I open that, and there is this nose, and I test that in this cool look. In the same way as before, I paint that area with this, and now there must be this shiny
Okay.
Okay, and now I have painted in this clear coat also in that area and all areas. And now this my mask is in new color. It is now blue and it is ready for installation. But of course I have to wait 1 hour that this my clear coat is dry and then it is ready for installation. Okay, that kind of information to you, and good paintings and be happy. Okay, and then of course next step is to take that my new grilles this protective cover tapes away, and this is like surface what I painted yesterday, and now I took away this my tape in here, and this is easy to remove in that way. I take this my old this protective tapes away in here. Okay, good. And this is important that we have high quality this tape what we are using, and that's I recommend this brand what is in here inside. The brand is Scott, and I have used that brand now about 30 to 40 years. This is excellent brand. Other name is 3M, but this Scott is excellent for this paint things, because there is this glue contact is so excellent, easy to insert and then easy to take out. Okay, and here is that part. And then this central part also. Okay, good, looks good. Okay, and here is something. This is this final part in. Okay, cool. And now this my grill mask is ready for installation. And there is really situation that way when we install this mask, that there is this another side, there are those nuts, 1, 2, 3, there's seven pieces. And then, actually there's bolts, and here are those nuts in my hand. And these nuts goes in here, and this is 10 millimeter bolt, and I only fasten these nuts in here, and then this joint is ready. Look, there is this nut, it looks like that. This is specific nut, and there is then this target area where I install that firstly in using my hands, and then final step is to take this 10 millimeter wrench, like in here there's 1, 0, 10, and then do this final fastening using the threads. So easy. Okay, and then we go to install this new mask grille. And first I take this my bolts away and everything looks good. Okay, it looks good. And there are these my bolts. And then we go to take out firstly this old grille.